Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about an op-amp as a non-inverting amplifier, and we will also derive the gain of non-inverting amplifier. In our previous video of op-amp as an inverting amplifier, we actually derived the value of closed loop gain, and in that video we also discussed about the virtual ground concept, which is very important that if there is no physical connection between the two terminals of op-amp, input terminals of op-amp, still the voltage between them is same, and that kind of concept is known as virtual ground concept. In this video we will use this concept again. So let us first look at the block diagram of an op-amp, then we will derive the gain. Op-amp as non-inverting amplifier. So this is the circuit diagram in which feedback resistor is already connected. That's why we are actually interested in calculating the gain, which is ACL. ACL is nothing but closed loop gain. Again, I'll repeat the same point that if the feedback resistor is connected in op-amp, I'll use this term closed loop gain. If there is no feedback resistor in an op-amp, we will use this term open loop gain. So there's a difference between this closed loop gain and open loop gain. Now we will use the virtual ground concept. Let's say this is our terminal A and this is our terminal B. As it is already specified that this is a non-inverting amplifier, it means that the voltage has to be applied at positive terminal. That's why V input is applied at B, that is positive terminal. By virtual ground concept, I can say that the potential at A, that is VA, will be equals to VB. As VB is equals to V input, so VA is also equals to V input. Let us give it as equation 1. Our purpose is to calculate the value of closed loop gain, that is V naught upon V input. So this is our circuit in which this is I input, this is IF, let me give it as RL, and here this is of course V naught. Don't get confused that I'm writing here. Of course, it is the voltage which is across RL as well as across this RF. In order to explain this point, I'm just replacing my circuit diagram with the help of this new circuit diagram in which we are not using any op-amp. We are just trying to calculate the value of V input and V naught. As we are saying that this is our A terminal, and let's say this is ground, this is V input. We are just trying to calculate the value of V input as well as the value of this V naught. That's why we are replacing this circuit diagram with the help of a simpler one. So don't get confused by this next diagram. What we are actually doing, that we are keeping this point, this VA. So we will use this A terminal as V input, and let's say this is our point A. If I'll keep this point as ground, so the difference between them is V input, and V input is connected to R input. Similarly, this V input is connected with this terminal is connected with RF, and this will be equals to V naught. Basically, in order to just calculate the value of V input and V output, we are just replacing it with the simpler one. Don't get confused by this next circuit diagram. So let's say this is our current, which is equals to I input, and if this is V input, so V input will be equals to R input multiply by input, because this is ground, this is equals to 0, so I can say that V input will be equals to R input into I input, and as current is flowing from low to high, that's why I'll use this minus sign here. Similarly, V naught. Now this V naught here, this is V naught and this is V input, and current, let's say the current here is IF. So what I'll do, that if I'm taking V naught as high reference at high voltage, and let's say this is our low voltage, it doesn't matter at all, for our reference we are using that. So V naught minus V input will be equals to RF into IF, and along with a minus sign. Again the same point, that current is flowing from low to high, that's why I'm using this minus sign. Let me put the value of this V input in this equation. So V input will be equals to, from this equation 1, V input minus or minus plus V input will be equals to, I'm just taking this R input and I input to this side, so V naught will be equals to minus of RF into IF and minus of R input into I input. So V naught will be equals to minus sign common, I input common, RF plus R input. This is very important point, that IF is equals to I input. We are actually repeating this point, and we already discussed in our previous video that due to the high input impedance, the value of IF into N I input, this current, feedback resistor current, and this input current, they both are equal because of high input impedance. That's why I'm replacing this IF by I input, and V naught will be equals to minus of RF plus R input into I input. Let us say this is our equation 2. As our closed loop gain is equals to V naught upon V input, I'll put this value here. So V naught will be RF plus R input into I input. And from equation 1, this is our equation 1, that V input is equals to minus of R input into I input. So I'll put this equation into the main equation. So minus and minus will be cancelled. Similarly, I input and I input will be cancelled. So what I can say, that RF plus R input upon R input, ACL will be equals to R input by R input, this is our closed loop gain for non-inverting amplifier. One point which we need to note down is that the gain for inverting amplifier was minus of RF by R1. Let me call it as R input. Similarly, the gain for inverting amplifier ACL is, and as we know that this inverting amplifier stands for negative terminal, that's why the gain is also negative in nature. And similarly, for non-inverting, it is a positive, as input is applied, of course, at the positive terminal. That's why our gain is also positive. So it is just a point that we need to remember while performing the numericals, while calculating the value, that if your gain is positive in nature, it means that it is correct answer, because for the case of non-inverting amplifier, it has to be positive. So 1 plus RF by R input. In order to remember both the gains, we are trying to write down in terms of RF divided by R input. It is very easy to remember. ACL for the inverting, minus of RF by R input, minus stands for negative terminal. Similarly, ACL for non-inverting, 1 plus RF by R input, and it has to be positive because it is applying, input is applying at non-inverting terminal. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and subscribe to eKida.